Okay.
Yes.
100 life incoming.
You have to attack first.
No. We're destroying dinosaurs as well. Get out of here, Timber Gorge. See you later, my friend.
Kame. Kame.
Yes. What's up, nerds? It's time to enter the arena with me, Righty Knight, and joining me this week and every week, Toralf Toffel Severin.
Hello!
And Jamin Kauf.
That's me.
That's you. The three of us assembled once again to get it done with another ridiculous... Oh, excuse me. Another potent and powerful deck, this time based around Firesong and Sunspeaker. This was a suggestion that a viewer sent in to us, and we're very, very happy to execute on this plan. Firesong and Sunspeaker, in conjunction with Star of Extinction, gain a billion squid in life, but... They said, why stop there? Star of Extinction, True Fire Captain, the old Boros Reckoner combo. We're going to try to 20 someone out of the game here today.
It's pretty obvious that you stop after Star of Extinction. Like, history-wise, also.
Yeah. This should end the game one way or the other in the same way that it ended the Age of the Dinosaurs. That's right.
Whoever has, like, more cards in hand after this resolves should win the game, right? Because, like... Everything just died, and like the game should be over.
The game should be over, but hopefully we'll also be on, you know, a three-figure life total if we've got these little cows out as well. So we'll see how that goes. But it's kind of like a bad control deck on top of
it's an
these
interesting
guys.
Boros
Sorry,
control deck.
Excuse me, an interesting Boros control deck. We've got lava coils, lightning strikes to keep Monist early, deafening clarions to clear the board as well, revitalized cycles through our deck a little bit. You know, early removal, most of which works really well with Firesong and Sunspeaker later on, the exception being Settle the Wreckage there. And also, Jamin, you've sort of suggested this inclusion of ramp.
Well, if you want to play 6 and 7 drops, you might want to generate additional mana, because like you're playing 24 lands. You would need to draw 6 of those, which is 1/4 of them. So yeah, that's a lot of lands to draw. So we help ourselves a little bit by generating treasures. And Boros Locket, which is less of a treasure and more of draft chaff.
Yeah, not so much a treasure, but you know, we just sort of, you know, it was lying around in the you know, at GPs, how they've got the free cards box.
Yeah.
Pick these up.
That's where we found it, and then we straight up imported it into Arena.
Yeah, I just fed it straight into my CD-ROM drive, and then there we go. That's a little trick, a little life hack for MTG Arena. That's what they don't want you to know. Anyway, there'll be a full deck guide up on ChannelFireball.com in a couple of days. But boys, that's not the only thing you can find on ChannelFireball.com. Now available for pre-order, Ravnica Allegiance. It comes out very soon. I'm so excited about the new cards. Boys, what are your favorites? Come on. I mean, no, you know, it's late January, right? We know all the cards in the set by now.
Everything has been spoiled.
Yep.
And we have... I really like the new blue card.
Oh, which one? Because there are a couple that I had my eye on.
Which one do you have your eye on?
Well, see, I really like the that instant that is...
Yeah.
That, you know, I just think it's really flexible. You know the one that I'm talking about? The one that costs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6?
Yes, of course.
Yeah. And the art on it as well. What an amazing job.
I can't remember the art,
like, it's got all the flashing kind of lights and the colors really nice, you know, and I'm really looking forward to playing with this card. Who's your favorite planeswalker from the new set, Toffel?
I really love Kaya.
Oh, yeah?
We haven't seen Kaya since...
Conspiracy.
Yeah, exactly. And she actually looked really... like underwhelming, but playing with her in Highlander, she's so great. And the new abilities are great. What do you think about the melee ability, Jamin?
All right, well, I think I have to give it up here. We have no idea about the new cards.
Yes, we won, Toffel. Yeah, we beat him. We beat him. We're recording this in December. We don't have any idea what's going on in Ravnica Allegiance. I mean, we've seen like Lavinia and that, like, what is it, the 3/3 hexproof thing? It's pretty good.
Yeah, the Growl Exproof, the Growl Spell Speaker. We also saw Addendum from Azurus, which seems like an amazing ability.
Yeah, a lot of tension with Teferi there, but we don't have access to the full card list just yet. So those are our best.
But you will.
But you will.
You hear it. Yeah.
And And if you want to, if you don't want to just look at these cards on, you know, on online, if you want to hold them IRL in paper on in your actual hands, my friends, ChannelFireball.com is your place to go. You can pre-order everything from Ravnica Allegiance now, including if you live in the US, sealed product. Get a draft going, fill up that trade binder with all the new cards. You're gonna have a great time. And ChannelFireball.com is your place to go for Ravnica Allegiance. And I mean, I'm saying this in December without seeing the full set, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a real good one.
In the past, Wizards has done a decent job at designing fun cards.
Yep, yep. We've seen a huge uptick, especially with play design coming in. And so I'm sure Ravnica Allegiance is definitely going to be one for the book. So head to channelfireball.com, pre-order them now. They'll head to you as soon as they're available, and you can get across them. But right now, we're going to get across.
It's time for the Constructed Event.
The Constructed Event. Hidden away this time. Hidden away. And this was the other giveaway that we're playing in December because Amazonians play anything drafters on. Hello, future Riley, watching this in the future in January. I'm very sorry you don't get to play one of the best draft formats that has ever been made, and there's no irony there. I loved playing that.
Yep, casting your cards for free, which was the stipulation in that draft format. Yep. That was really fun.
It was so good.
Back then, you know.
Back in the good old days. Month. Back in 2018, when cards were free. Ooh, she's a bit loud. I'm gonna bring the volume down a little bit here.
Given that we're on the draw, I think this is keepable.
Keep this hand. All right.
It's a bit awkward that the captain dies to the clarion.
Yeah, and but also
it
doesn't...
also gains lifelink.
It gains lifelink, so it can't attack. Well, this will put us to the test.
Yeah, one of the interactions between those cards was that it gains lifelink before dying.
So the damage it deals to the player gains life, right?
Yeah, exactly. Which is not intuitive, right? It's not...
Not really.
So does it? So it has lifelink at the point that it deals the damage.
Yeah, because the dying of state-based damage happens after the spell resolves.
Jeez.
We're not calling the 2-1.
Oh, right, of course, then we can clean up the... sure.
No, it doesn't get the...
Oh, it doesn't even get the thing. Okay.
No, all right, but still.
So one way or the other.
One way they would get the lifelink token, but this way they don't.
Yeah, one way or the other. Woo. We're going to get you. We're going to get you.
One way or another.
Oh, and here's the other.
Oof. Their board is protected against Clarion.
Yeah, they've gone down to the local insurance dealer and they've said, "Listen, I need some earplugs. I want some insurance for a deafening Clarion." We still cast it there, right?
So what is the bodyguard protecting?
It's protecting the Sky Marcher Aspirant.
Yeah. So we effectively only get rid of a 2-1 by casting Clarion.
So are we coiling the Dusk again?
What do you mean? No. We get rid of this and this, and then that creates a 1-1.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think Clarion is still better because we might need Labako for... I don't know. It's hard. Magic is a hard game.
Magic is a very hard game. And this is why we play decks that are quote-unquote interesting. Because then if we get stuff wrong, we're just playing an interesting deck.
It's much easier to play well when you don't care about playing well.
When your investment level is low. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Yep. All right. All right, we're in...
Wow.
We're in decent shape here. This and a
I reckon
lava
we
coil.
Just cast...
What, Captain?
Pillage?
Oh, the pillage.
I mean... Everything is fine. Can we just block with the creature? Like, what is going to happen to it? Anything?
Not really, no. But then we don't get to, like, deal 20 damage. But I guess we have to play it, yes. It does block very well.
It does block very well.
Question is if it... going to be killed because our opponent didn't play anything on 3.
Yeah, maybe they've just got mono removal. Or we could see heroic reinforcements here.
Ooh, that would have us take 7.
Jeez. Mm.
Still fine.
It's alright. Okay, oh, the Tribunal. Alright, well that's fine, whatever.
We didn't care about the captain anyway.
No, of course. Yeah. We have a spare.
Yeah, now treasure map should... start scrying, so we can flip it at some point.
All right. So I just get rid of this as well?
Yeah, I think so.
I think so too. Ooh.
All right.
Maybe not.
Keep it.
Yeah, keep it and take the damage next turn, and then hope they don't have reinforcements.
Yep. Okay. All right. So not getting rid of that.
No. If they have reinforcements, we're taking 9. On the edge.
I think our creature-based matchup isn't that terrible, to be honest. Because we've got so much removal.
Yep.
Once the Sunspeaker and Fire Flamer...
yes. Yep.
As Sunspeaker and Fire Thrower.
Hits the battlefield all of those game live, which is pretty decent.
Yeah, it's insane. Yeah. I mean, even a Deafening Clan with a Firesong and Sunspeaker. I mean, it's no Star of Extinction. But you do get a ton of life.
A fair bit of life.
And you can then get to attack with your lifelinking 4/6 as well, which is pretty hot. This thing just will not die. Nah. She has proper earmuffs on. They just can't hear a thing.
It's
think of Deafening Clarion in that way.
Keep that.
It's when your parents hold your eyes when somebody said something wrong.
Bottom it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And the bodyguard jumps to their side and covers the ears.
Don't know.
The bodyguard
has to hold that lantern on the upward.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. She doesn't have her hands free to block her ears. Oh, how lucky can you be? I didn't even see that.
In traditional arena boys fashion.
Yep.
We lose the first one.
Game one goes down. We were too busy making great goofs about the Spy Sky Marcher aspirant, and our opponent was just like, "Oh well, all right, enough of this." Fun police came in and put us all under arrest. Ooh.
Is heroic reinforcements the fun police?
I also realized. One second, sorry, we'll come back to that. We forgot to change our avatar.
Well, Teferi.
Teferi all the way.
Teferi all the way. Okay, all right, I'm behind it. Heroic reinforcements, I think, is very much the fun police.
Like, it's the reinforcements needed if someone is having too much fun.
Too much fun, exactly. Yeah. Well, you know, there's.
We need reinforcements.
We need backup. They're having just too much fun over here.
Alright, these lava cords should clean up against green decks.
Yeah, I see by basic forest, and I'm a happy man when I'm playing this deck. Oh,
I want to propose a change.
A change?
Fun police is the police against fun, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But shouldn't the fun police bring joy? Shouldn't fun police be something positive?
I think it's fun police in the sense that it's like crime police. They're preventing the crime. Whereas, I see what you mean. The fun police should enforce fun. What we're worried about is fun burglars.
I want to suggest that fun police now is a positive turn.
Yes. Okay, so we're the fun police and they're the fun, you know, burglars.
I think it's too late to change the connotation of fun police.
It's never too late to change anything.
We're going to try to reclaim the term fun police.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to put a stop in the upkeep here.
Oh, very good. That's usually something that...
Okay.
What?
I'm pretty sure I did that. I'm pretty sure I did that. I'm pretty sure I clicked that button.
You can remove
now
it.
Now you have to remove it, and otherwise it stops next turn or something.
Yeah, but that's fine. I'll probably want to anyway. All right, let's
go. Right. We probably have to kill that knight, otherwise it does scary things.
Ooh, I think we want to die.
Yep. But don't worry, we'll get it done without it.
Yep. This is the good thing about playing very bad cards. Especially if your opponent's playing discard or if you've got scry abilities, it always feels very good to scry or discard a bad card.
Mm, yeah, because you can say
this is a problem here. Alright.
Let's find fight with fire.
Alright, scry. Did you mean treasure map?
No, I didn't. That's way too slow.
Alright.
That's why I said fight with fire, not treasure map.
Aren't we winning next turn?
By playing this?
Yeah. No.
Or just by
flipping
that.
Oh, don't we have the combo for 20?
Yeah.
Oh. We can just bypass this altogether. Oh.
Oh. We have a combo.
So we just need this not to die, which is...
Yep.
Seems probable. Seems likely.
Yeah, out of a green red deck.
I think...
Hopefully they spent their red mana on dinosaurs.
Do you know what the problem is, though?
They're only on 8?
They're only on 8.
Yeah. Mm.
Boo!
Oh, no!
Boo!
I see a different problem emerging.
Yeah. Here I was thinking that dinosaur decks would spend their mana on dinosaurs.
Yeah, I know. Our opponent not playing in the spirit of the game here. So, what now, this?
But we're in the spirit of the game. They're dinosaurs. We have Star of Extinction.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We're trying to... Again, okay, so you have
what
to...
What is up with the upkeep stuff?
You have to click this a long time ahead. That's not great. All right, so these two?
We can just play Firesong, right?
Oh, this game's
What could possibly go wrong?
What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, damn. That's usually the point where everything goes wrong.
Usually it is, yes. We don't want that, right? No.
Just one lands, I think.
Then we might, we can even cast the star next turn. Okay, that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything works out in the end. It actually, everything matters in the end. Usually, like, in the end, it doesn't matter.
I want to be the burglar police here. That is not a saying.
The burglar police.
The burglar police.
Okay, that's a good... All right, this is looking good. I'm really into the fact that there are going to be a bunch of dinosaurs on the battlefield for our Star of Extinction. Yes.
We don't lock, right? That might be a combat trick.
Oh my goodness.
Don't block.
Don't block? All right.
I mean,
go
there's
to five.
No way that they have anything, right?
And also, let's just remind ourselves. We're about to gain 100 life.
It's about
literally
the statement.
Wait, what?
All right. No,
wait,
you have to move
first
to your main phase. No, don't attack.
Riley, attack first.
I'm not going to attack.
You have to click main.
Okay.
Yes.
100 life incoming.
You have to attack first.
And.
No.
We're destroying dinosaurs as well. Get out of here, Timber Gorge. See you later, my friend.
Kame. Kame.
Woo. But
oh, no, they have a 3-3.
In an egregious flavor violation. Okay, let me just read this card again. It says Star of Extinction, not Star of Partial Extinction. What is this? Can I tell you something, guys? I think we need to teach our opponent a little lesson here. I think we need to go back to the Age of the Dinosaurs for a second time and let them know exactly how things turned out 65 million years ago.
Well, you know what will happen again?
There will still be a dinosaur left over. Wow.
What is this? Alternate world history with
it's
Remain.
One of those crocodiles that survived.
Oh, this is the precursor of the modern chicken.
Oh, was chicken in dinosaur land?
Chickens are direct descendants of dinosaurs.
Isn't that like the answer to what was first, the chicken or the egg?
Yes, and it is.
What was first, the chicken or the dinosaur?
Well, that one's a little easier. But it was actually, 100% for sure. I shouldn't apply that land, actually, in case we draw Pirate's Pillage.
Wait. So are we destroying it? Because it kind of is pressuring us.
Yeah, I know. I mean, how many?
Like, it's just 33 turn clock.
Yeah.
Can't just ignore that.
We can't just ignore that.
Yeah, we're passing the turn.
Okay. There is actually an answer to which came first, the chicken or the egg. And it is the egg.
Yeah, of course, because dinosaurs laid eggs.
I mean, you can take dinosaurs out of it completely, but effectively, the first thing that hatched, the first egg that hatched into the first chicken was laid by the very last, not a chicken. So it's actually been solved. Let's cast this.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, well, maybe we draw land.
Just cast Clarion Worm and Clarion. And
okay. Then. Yeah. Also, make sure to give our creatures life.
Of course. Of course, Yamin.
Somehow,
okay, so now it's kind of even, right? We have about the same amount of lands. We have a few cards more, okay?
Yeah, I guess. But apart from that, it's even.
Yeah.
We're on 96 life.
Nice. I mean, 12, 96. Nobody has a clock. Like, the clock is the same.
No, that's it. And the clock is exactly the same. And on a cosmic scale, 96 and 12 are not that far apart. You know, if we're talking in the range of millions and billions, the numbers are basically the same.
I always talk about life totals in the range of millions and billions.
Yeah.
I don't even start counting before then. Like,
no.
Shock, take two. I don't know.
I've not it yet. Don't even change your life pad. This is going really well.
I want to see that in a GP when you go like, could you please write your life total? I'm sorry. I have like 20 life. I don't even write for like under 500.
Yeah. I didn't even get out of bed.
I'm around 17. That's how playtesting usually goes. 10 turns into the game, your opponent asks you, wait, how much life are you on? I don't know, like, probably 15?
But to be fair, I had this situation once where I had about infinite life and my opponent was attacking. and we were writing down negative numbers, like 200,000 minus 14, because it was hard to add from, and the judge told me I was not allowed to do that. So I had to write down the actual number.
I could have added four turns or three turns to our clock if I'd kept that on top.
What a rookie
fool.
Mistake.
What a fool I am.
The stop just went away. Look at that. Okay. You don't have the stop anymore. What is happening?
Yeah,
the stop
signs are. We need the city council workers to come out and fix up some of this road infrastructure here. I'll take one. Go to 95. Can I just say, massive props to our opponent here.
Like for playing on.
Yeah, for thinking that they can get us down from. Okay, all right. Here we go.
How about gaining another 9 life?
Yeah, check this out. This is so sick. Actually, I'm going to do it next turn so we can attack with it as well and gain even more.
Smart. Loyal.
Thank you. I hope you appreciate it. Ah, perfect. All right. Another land. All
right. Another land. It plays right into our master plan.
Yes.
By now, we can kick fight with fire.
We should have played a Banefire.
Ah, yes. Gain X life.
All right. Any attacks,
very
opponent?
Powerful.
Man, they are just not giving up, huh? I love it. All right. Yep, my turn. And Deafening Clarion. Lifelink.
Gain 13.
Gain, I don't know how much. A lot.
I'm around 110 now. Like, somewhere near. Oh. It's 16 life even.
Yep, because this has lifelink and did damage as well. I mean, I'm just glad that MTGA is here to process all of these calculations.
Yeah.
You know, to be honest.
I would have messed this up in a GP.
Yeah. Oh, we've got two treasure codes.
111 life. Isn't that beautiful?
Oh, mate.
It's the perfect life total
to end
it on.
It's the perfect life total. All right, I guess I'll draw cards.
Sure.
I guess I'll draw cards.
That is strong.
Oh, and now we can go.
Now it's Firesong and Sunspeaker and Firesong and Sunspeaker.
Oh.
Lightning strike upstairs.
Play Helm of the Host. That would be cool.
Game three.
Yeah. I guess multiple instances of lifelink wouldn't stack with Helm of the Host.
Yeah, unfortunately. Give everything double lifelink. It's not as sick as it sounds. All right.
On the board.
I do like that our opponent made us earn it. You know, we had to work hard for it. Nothing comes for free in this life, boys.
Nothing. Except for lifelink on your spells.
Yes. Yeah, that's true. I don't like this hand very much.
Do you draw two lands on, four draw steps, Riley?
No.
Ah, that's better.
Oh, no, that's much better.
That's much better. All right.
It has the locket.
Yes.
Oh, that's such a sick curve. Turn two treasure map, turn three locket plus scry. That's actually pretty good.
It always feels pretty good when you use the mana from a rock that you play the turn that you play it. And
it doesn't happen very often. Efficient. Yep.
So, sweet. All right. Do we want this? Probably not, right?
No, we already have enough. And we'll
okay.
probably draw into more. Our opponent also on 6 cards.
It can only be a good thing for us. Okay.
And I'll take most bets that our opponent is playing Merfolk.
Yes, alright. Yeah, that seems reasonable. The Hinterland Harbor is not a commonly played land.
3, 2... Oh, no!
Alright.
Oh.
We're playing...
So what's...
Tobofog?
Oh, yeah,
Tobofog. Maybe Moldrotha.
Who plays Moldrotha?
Yeah.
Wow, who would do such a thing?
Who would play Moldrotha? Well, if they're playing Moldrotha, they're going very heavy on the blue sources. Okay. Okay.
Wow.
All right. Well, boys,
Things are getting spicy in here.
We are on the clock.
Do we have a clock in our deck? We have to get to the... Star Mentor part.
Yeah.
11 mana.
Easy.
Usually I strongly agree with your click efficiency economy, Riley.
Yeah.
But right now, scrying right now was like a really
bad
move.
Oh, it's actually very bad. No. See, it's perfect. See?
Ah, yeah. You played it perfectly.
I don't know what you're saying. And watch this. Two more stinkers. Ready? Nope. You don't have to be ready, guys. You got a long time to go. You got a long time yet. All right. Man, this is where we would really use, like, because this doesn't...
Nothing too bad happened.
Wow.
Our opponent is on the turbo mill plan.
Yep.
Exciting stuff.
Auto pass just does not do what it says. You're like, hey, you want to automatically pass through everything? Sure, just click here. It's like, all right, I'd like that. Okay.
I feel like that's one of the downsides that Arena still has.
I guess just play this and...
Yes. And then pass.
Put a stop in the upkeep, see if it actually works this time.
Yep. No, and also scry at end of turn.
Oh, to flip this, yep, so we can draw cards. Alright.
Yep.
Okay.
So now we have two treasure maps, so we can actually get to 11. Easy.
Oh yeah, right.
We just can't lose all our win options, but so far we
But
can.
We do play four captains, right?
Four captains and oh god.
Four captains,
oh,
three stars.
God.
Okay. Well, that's
this
happening.
Is turning into a fast clock.
I think this is how our opponents feel when they matched up against us. Keep that, right?
No.
No?
We have to keep it.
We have to keep it. We need it.
It's one of the combos.
Oh, yes. Wow. See, that's how well I play magic.
Okay. All right.
If I said scry.
No, we want to draw this.
But we want to counter on the treasure map.
Oh, I see. All right. Okay. Sorry.
No worries. And now we can draw with the cove because we do need
Do we want to scry first?
I guess. Yeah, sure.
That was a good idea.
Did you want to like imply that usually Riley didn't know?
Yes.
That would be rude.
Yes.
Yeah. No, just owning it as well, top of which I like. All right. Come on. Hey!
Wow.
All right. Can we cast this though?
How much mana do we have?
We've got a lot, but
six, seven, eight, nine.
Will it live?
Why wouldn't it? Just pass. Oh no! Not now! Not now! No! Don't cast it now. They might.
That's what I'm saying. Will it live?
Yeah. We'll cast it in the same turn as the star.
So we're gonna one-shot them with 11 mana.
Yes, of course.
The 11 mana OTK. All right. Let's get it done.
I mean, that's not the worst ratio. 11 mana win the game.
It's not too bad. No, it's a good rate.
That would be a decent ramp payoff.
Yeah.
Imagine if they printed that.
Just 11 mana, sorcery, you win the game.
Yeah. I mean, Omniscience is somewhat window the game with 10 mana.
You got to do a lot of other work, though.
Yeah,
all right.
You have to have lots of other cards and stuff.
So, I don't want to make any errors. So, am I doing anything, scrying, not doing nothing, right? Just
No.
Okay.
So, how much do we have? We have six. We don't have
11 mana next turn.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
So, we have to pass one more turn. Once more.
Wait, but now we have one counter. Do we even have 11 next turn?
Yes, we do, right? 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. We spend 1, gain 3. Yeah, we have exactsies next turn.
All right. And all we need is our opponent not to have a counterspell.
Well...
What are the odds they would have a counterspell? That would be very lucky.
Yeah, I mean, how lucky can one player be, right? Okay, so scry.
Yeah.
They might just have, like, mono fogs or something.
I think we keep this, right?
Yeah. Yep. Do we have all stars left?
There were probably some milled. There's at least one.
Okay, so
we still have one left.
Still got one star left. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So my turn.
Go into our turn.
Draw.
And then
flip this.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, one shot.
Don't miss your chance.
All right.
To be fair, Starve Extinction is a really big shot.
It is. I mean, it's hard to miss, given how big it is.
Oh, boys! By the way, I'll use my one time on this.
Okay. One time.
That was like three times by now, but
that's all right.
Oh, you gotta manually sack all the treasures. Don't forget to add one red. Yeah.
All right. One time. One time beating mono blue mill or bant mill or whatever it is. With Boros wrecking a combo. Yes. Our opponent. Strong. Oh no!
Okay, but this is fine.
I mean, it's fine. We've got the lightning strike in hand, but our opponent must be sitting there being like, nah, I've got it. I've got this one locked up. There's no way they can win. There's no two-card combination that does 20 damage, but...
How many cards do we have in our library?
Heaps.
I think we might be... Oh, 20.
I think we might be dead, says Yumi. Oh, dear. All
right. Well, we're milling 8, right? So if they have... No.
Yeah. So they need draw 2.
Okay.
And then another draw.
Yeah, they need to draw 3 cards total.
But we win in the upkeep.
Oh,
we don't. We don't have to draw a card. Assuming
the stop works,
we win in the upkeep.
Mate, if this stop doesn't work, that would be the most tilting.
It's gonna be so bad, but hopefully, it's gonna. All right.
It worked. Just do it now. Don't risk anything.
Yep.
We should have used the treasure code, but easy game. Nothing that could stop us. That was really good.
It's had it all. Had some smiles, some frowns. There was some laughs, some tears, ups and downs, everything.
Also, like casting Revitalize to survive is kind of flavorful.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Like you're gonna take 20 damage.
You're literally revitalizing.
Yeah, you just quaff a little healing potion.
That was a very nice game.
That was super sweet. Yeah. You keep this. All right.
Yeah.
Treasure
map. It has the combo. Ready to go.
Oh, it does too.
It has the combo of treasure map and 2 lands.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the other combo.
Treasure map is, I think, one of the most underrated cards in Standard.
I don't think it's underrated anymore. All the Jeskai lists play it, right?
Yeah.
I guess not all of them.
No.
But like the Jeskai list that did well in that one GP.
Okay, cool.
Thank you.
All right. Scry? I think we should scry.
We definitely should scry.
Yeah. I'm not quite sure.
Oh, now? Oh, yeah. Toffel is actually right because...
Well, we have a stop. Okay, the stop is gone. So I figured out. As soon as your opponent... goes into the a situation where they can't make any plays, it passes the turn because this went off while that was still attacking. So if your opponent does because they did this pre-combat, that turn so if you
that makes sense.
If you do it in their second main phase and they have no plays, it's too late. All right, should we scry?
I think so.
Toffel?
This is not very threatening, Ryan.
Yeah.
All right, let's scry.
Good thing we scryed.
I'm very glad we scryed. All right, draw, please. Oh, dear. Okay.
That was a weak draw. I would have drawn a land there.
Yeah, I know. Well, I'm still learning. Again, got so much left to learn, you mean?
Yeah.
Okay, well.
So now we probably don't scry because...
Because we really need to hit the... Well, it's too late anyway. taunting us. Our deck is taunting us. All right.
Whoa! Good news is, next turn we have some mana.
Yep. Next turn, at the latest, we'll get there.
I don't think we need the third Deafening Clarion. Hopefully.
How devastating would Heroic Reinforcements be right now?
How devastating is this card?
Now
we're settling, right?
Yeah. Oh, mate. Our opponent getting all the lands. So we pass.
Now we should have scryed.
Yeah. But well. We just passed, discarding a captain.
Yeah, we don't need... we need one. We need exactly one to be there when the meteor hits it.
Okay, yes.
That's fine. That's all right. That's good, actually. Yeah.
Good game!
Wow!
Wow! Can you do good game back?
Good game. Really, really good game. Yeah. You know, let's play it out though, just for fun.
Let's get out the token.
We'll keep that. Is there anything that we could have? I guess
I
not.
I don't think so.
I don't think so. And they still. Oh my goodness! I definitely shouldn't have done that because this is just 4 mana.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this resolves.
both of these resolve.
This resolves.
Then...
Settle the wreckage. Also resolves. I'll target you, my friend.
Oh, man.
I mean, that is... Oh, that is savage.
BM gone wrong.
Yeah, exactly. Mate. BM gone wrong.
That was...
What a heady, rich aroma. I love it. So, the question is now, how many basics is our opponent actually going to be able to put in play? They've got 48 cards.
Probably.
Oops. Yeah, no, you're damn right, oops, mate.
Nice.
Nice as well. All right, you're getting a bit mouthy for me, my friend. Might mute you, I think.
He only said nice things, though.
Yeah.
Except for nice.
Except for the good game and the nice and the oops.
Dang.
So, wow, 10 basics. All right.
I guess we do die to Banefire.
So...
We just pillage away one of our captains.
Yeah, we can't even cast... We can't even cast them. All right.
Why can't we cast
them? Because we got Treasure
because
Cove.
Because Treasure Cove
this
only...
This colorless?
Yep.
Yep.
All
right. Boys.
How can... That doesn't make any sense that a Treasure Cove makes colorless.
Can I say? I like our chances here.
They're decent, right?
They're pretty.
But the game was...
They're pretty
the game
decent.
Was already over.
Oh, yeah, they said good game.
Yeah,
I think they just acknowledged that we had settled and told us that it was a good game, but they lost.
Good game. All right.
Yeah, let's not draw cards, actually.
No,
we need
I don't think so.
We need more cards.
Oh man, all of this is so, how do you call it?
Satisfying?
Mm. Yeah, like, damn.
Deserved?
Yeah, justice. Yeah. Justice, mate. I'm really glad we put that one settle in because that was a classic settle moment there.
Yep.
All right.
Keep them honest.
Keep them honest. Play,
Yep.
Our special friends here. Yep.
Oh, I guess actually True Fire Captain would be the play, but whatever.
Because we can win.
It doesn't matter. We can
turn.
Do that next turn.
Do that next turn. Yep.
Because we don't die anytime soon. Oh, no. Can't attack anymore.
Can't attack. How terrible. Whatever we're going to do.
They took away our most important action.
All right.
Now it's True Fire Captain time.
Yeah,
don't forget to lightning strike them at end of turn.
Oh, because, yeah, you're right. They're on...
They're on 22.
They're on 22.
So, yeah, Star wouldn't kill them. And we don't want to attack.
And we gain 40 as well. 60? Sorry, excuse me, 60.
But we can also... Wait.
What?
Can't we... If we give... do we have Clarion?
Do we have mana?
No, we don't.
No, we don't have enough
If we
mana.
Give our captain lifelink before... we can
can gain even more.
Yeah, but we don't have enough mana.
We don't have mana. That's unfortunate.
So we can cast the Immortal Sun before...
Oh, just to give ourselves a chance.
Is it already over?
We're having so much fun.
Wait. Could you please say good game?
Oh, yes. That's very important. Very nice.
Taste it.
I love it.
Taste it, opponent.
I hope they don't concede.
What, in response to the star?
Yeah,
our opponent's a battler. Our opponent's a real battler. They're reading, like, okay, destroy target land. Yep, okay, well, I say, yes, all right.
Woo!
And then, my friend.
It's 29.
Yeah, and we're on 70, by the way. We could have been on more, chose not to. Don't even worry about it. You know how, you know, at primary school, you know, there's that kid who's like, you know, I can fly. And you're like, no, you can't. And like, yeah, I can. We'll do it then. No, I just don't want to. And
that's me whenever I lose a match.
Yeah, I could win. I just don't want to. But that was us just then because we could have been on like 400 million life. We just didn't want to be. This hand seems all right.
Definitely keepable, probably. Yeah. I would like
definitely
some
capable, probably.
Maybe
there's a high chance that it might probably be a definitely keepable hand.
In some cases.
Yeah, boys, I'm having a great time.
This deck is amazing to play.
This deck is just amazingly fun to play.
It really looked like a horrible pile of garbage fire. Like, honestly.
Oh dear. Toffles just got up this morning being like, oh, I have to record this stupid deck with these stupid idiots.
Well,
but now he's actually enjoying himself.
No, it's actually good. I was in a really bad mood today, right? Like, I was cranky and I just didn't enjoy the day. And then it knocked at my door, right?
Yeah.
Yo was there.
Who was there?
The fun police.
The fun police, they turned up.
The fun police.
And they said, like, we cannot accept that you're not having fun. Go record with this deck.
Lightning strike the druid.
Okay.
Well,
still,
I guess everything worked out.
Still lightning strike the druid?
Yeah, definitely. It's always nice if your opponent passes while having a mana dork, because you know they don't have use for their mana.
Yeah.
So if you kill their mana dork, they're probably not going to use their mana next turn either.
Sweet. Actually, that's a really good point. Unless they rip something here. Yeah, that's a great point.
One of my favorite plays is when they have other creatures and they say attack, right? And they're not attacking with the Llanowar Elf.
Creature. Oh, and then just killing the Llanowar Elf.
In combat, killing the creature and they go like,
mate, Toffel with the next level plays.
Should we settle this?
Well, let's settle this.
Yeah, let's settle this outside.
Should we settle this once and for all?
Yeah. All right. Let's go outside and settle this.
Yeah.
Do we?
Meet me in the car park, Charging Monstrosaur, and we will settle this like dinosaurs. I wouldn't mind having a fist fight with a Charging Monstrosaur. I feel like I'd win.
Well, their fists couldn't reach you.
Exactly. I feel like if the only thing you're allowed to do is use...
Okay, I have a question, Riley.
Okay.
Who would you rather fight? One Jamin-sized Charging Monstrosaur?
Yeah.
Or five Toffel-sized Charging Monstrosaurs?
Probably just the one.
What? You think
he's
you
enormous.
Could take on me as a charging monster?
No, sword? But I don't think I could take on five of any like reasonable size. I know you're very
but
small.
But you can kick them much easier.
I know that's true, but there's still five of them. Like, I don't have five legs. Well, you need six legs to do five kicks, wouldn't you?
Oh. What about a roundhouse kick?
Let's gain life.
I'd have I'd have to do a big, like, whirlwind kick. So just both of these, right?
Yep.
But then our thing dies.
Well, good thing we have a backup one.
Yeah.
Or backup two.
Can we wait a turn?
I guess we can.
Get some more.
Toffel, stop being reasonable.
All right.
We'll wait a turn.
No attacks. Nope.
That wasn't the...
No attacks.
No attacks. Attack with all.
I've started to use the space bar. I'm still getting used to the control. Still getting used to the, you know, how she handles.
You know what would be a really good name for, like, a restaurant?
Go on.
Is it Space Bar?
What is
I guess it's more of a bar rather than a restaurant.
What is this? Guess we should have done it.
It says right on top of the card, it's Huatli Dinosaur Night.
Wait, that's even the other one.
It's the intro deck one.
Yep. Oh, amazing.
Okay.
And it's actually a lot better than the other one right now because
what does it do?
So we definitely need to double Clarion now.
We should have killed her last
We
time.
Should have, Toffel.
Yeah.
We have
Who was
to.
Against her?
You! let's double Clarion. Because otherwise it becomes a 9-8.
What does she do?
She puts 2 plus 1 counters.
Wait, does the last one really say minus 7 crap?
What?
Minus 7, dinosaurs get plus 1 so until end of turn. Yeah, because forever was just too strong.
Yeah, exactly.
for minus 7.
I mean, to be fair, she gains plus 2, right? Is that so?
She gets plus 2,
She does.
Yeah,
okay, so
minus 3.
I guess that's... Like, if you play in a more bad setting...
In a more casual setting.
Yeah, like, if you play those decks and she right away does this, might be strong.
I have never played with that card. I have no idea how good it is while playing it.
And you're a fiend for dinosaurs. You love dinosaurs.
Yep, but I don't like the dinosaur knight.
Okay. Well, luckily, they didn't play any more dinosaurs.
So she can't put plus one counters on stuff.
Yep.
Well,
so we need a star.
Oh, yes, right. I'm expecting Zakama this turn.
Yeah, this is not going to be good. Yep.
Ooh!
Day.
Well done.
Hello, it's future Jamin predicting plays.
Apparently, your thoughts are just future truths, mate. Apparently, it's odd that this is what you choose to use your psycho, like your clairvoyant abilities on predicting the plays of opponents in Magic: The Gathering.
Yeah, I feel like, would I predict like lottery numbers?
Exactly,
or
horse races. I feel like you could do a lot more.
I feel like there are too many dinosaurs on this world.
Yeah. Yes. I feel like we need some kind of mass extinction event, really.
Oh, wait. It's Future Jamin coming in.
Yeah.
Wait.
Oh, Future Jamin.
Oh, there's a star. There's a star on top. Mate, we're going to draw a star. How crazy is that?
Well, thank you for joining us, Future Jamin.
Can you upkeep the Field of Ruins?
I guess that prediction was only true if you upkeep Fielded of Ruin.
So if we'd shuffled the library one time, it would have put it on...
No,
yeah.
You said there's a Star of Extinction on top.
Yeah, you did.
That was a very specific sentence.
Yeah.
Future Jamin...
You're a fraud.
...has fraud. Ways of predicting the future that nobody else knows. We're dead, by the way, Riley. I don't know why we're scrying.
I understand that. Because... One thing I don't like about Arena is how readily people concede, and they don't let their opponent have the fun that they're trying to have. So you know what? I'm just going to hit here jamming spacebar until I get a picture of Sad Teferi on the battlefield. Actually, I'm getting bored. I'm just going to concede.
You're going to skip ahead to the picture of Sad Teferi.
Oh, we don't even get a Sad Teferi. He just disappears. He blows up. Well, of course
we should have those things, like a really Sad Teferi.
Yeah, that would be good.
Yeah, party to Ferry, and just a Ferry with two thumbs down and his tongue out, going bleh.
You can edit it in, right?
Yeah, that'd be pretty good. Oh, thanks. That'll only take me 6 hours to Photoshop properly.
Do you think Magic would be a better game if it didn't take like the story itself behind it so seriously?
No.
Okay, good discussion.
I don't think so. How much of an impact do you think it has on the...
I have no idea because I'm not one for like lore or stuff.
Yeah.
So like I don't really care about it. I think it would be funny to me, but maybe it wouldn't. I can't predict that. Or like
story is really important.
All right. If you say so, I'll believe that. I think we keep that on top because any land is fine.
I agree.
Yeah.
It sucks, but yep, you're right. Excuse me. All right.
Well, against Mono Red, how good is gaining 80 life against Mono Red? Can someone tell me?
I think gaining 80 life against most decks is pretty good, but against Mono Red, it's particularly good.
Mm.
Like, doing it is
going to be... So, we can scry. Yeah, we will definitely scry.
Yeah.
Let's see if it worked out. It did.
It did, yeah. You have to do it before they finish their actions for the turn. Oh, my goodness.
This turn, that's not good enough anymore.
No, we need a red source, right?
Larian.
Red source. Ding.
Woo! Red sauce. Is that ketchup?
Yep. It is.
Because it's red sauce.
As opposed to brown sauce. It's brown.
Chocolate?
No. Brown sauce is an actual thing. Like it's a you usually have it with your breakfast, like your bacon sandwiches here in the UK. By the way, just because people often hear me talking about the fact that I live in the UK, I'm not British, I'm Australian. Just to clear that. Up, Americans. A lot of Americans can't tell the difference. But I'm also colorblind, right? And,
bust it out!
This one?
No, the Sunspeaker.
Oh, right. Okay, sure. And brown sauce and tomato sauce both look exactly the same.
Did anyone ever trick you into eating one when you... the other?
They haven't tricked me, but I've definitely inadvertently, like, tricked myself.
That must be a really weird experience. Like,
it's weird because I don't dislike the flavor of either of them. Like, I quite like both of them. But when you eat something and you're expecting it to taste one way and it ends up tasting another, it kind of, you get the, like, ooh.
Yeah, I think it would be kind of like eating chocolate and then it tasting, like, salty or something.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's like
that.
Sounds
like an adventure.
yeah. It's like a little, you know, you don't exactly know how things are going to turn out.
A flavor adventure.
All right, let's gain some life.
Yeah, I think so. Now, it's actually relevant.
Okay. Prediction will be on like 20 life after this.
All right, yeah, okay. Let's quick. No, I'll say 22. I've got 22.
Yeah,
quick.
You mean? Come on.
Yeah, I have to agree with 22.
No, you got to have a different number.
Okay, 22.1.
Okay, Toffel.
107.
Okay. He's taking the Price is Right approach.
I think we should have done this before casting the Clarion, and it would have been I think most of us would have been off.
Well, I didn't calculate that. I just guessed.
The right play would have been to let us choose 22 and then say 18 and donut.
That would have been very good, actually. That would have been very powerful.
Riley, I have an important question. Do you want to win the game or do you want to have fun?
No. The other question is, do you want to win the, like, have fun or be right?
Okay.
Definitely attack.
All right.
And then we can cast Star of Extinction, but like then the board is left with a frenzy on our opponent's side of the board.
I think we'll leave it. I mean, it's only it's only 40 life. That's the problem.
Very weird.
Can we get more life when we let them play some creatures?
That's the thing. Like we let them play out their board, and it actually puts them further behind.
Oh no! Not more creatures. What do I ever do?
No,
that's really rude.
Yeah, let everything resolve. You're not making any mistake.
You're just going, no. Yeah. Like I've got some kind of say over what's going on. But
it would be sad if they have another lightning strike, but yeah, I guess we do have backup.
That's the thing, like them pointing a lightning strike at this is just them hoping they've got another... they don't have anything. That was just... this is a blind hope.
Okay. All right. Things worked out. So next turn, we probably have to settle the bird.
Let's get this bird to just settle down a little bit. We've got only 7 mana.
Stuff doesn't matter. We just play the captain.
All right.
We're not dying, right?
No. What could possibly go wrong?
I think also teching was kind of meh.
Yeah, because they just get the free block with the Phoenix, yeah. I suppose.
But they don't have a lightning strike on top. Otherwise, they would have... the only difference is shock. If they had a shock on top, that would
It prevents them from attacking with the with the Phoenix.
No.
Oh, gains haste, yeah, of course, doesn't it? Yeah. Yep. It's only a commonly played format staple that's been in Standard for over a year.
So now
maybe they make the mistake of killing the Firesong and Sunspeaker.
Yes, yeah, and then we can just 20 them. Alright, okay.
Alright, let's just 20 them either way. Woo, nice.
Wait, no. Oh, God.
All right.
I'm waiting.
For what?
Well, you just said wait.
No. Wait, if they kill now the mentor thing, then we might... Oh!
This is like when when you're playing a game, like a video game, and there's a quick time event, right? You know, and it's like, oh, you've got to, shoot the bad guy at the end of the game. And everything's set up. They're waiting there like that. And then eventually, if you just don't press anything, the game does it for you and robs you of the satisfaction. So, good.
Yeah.
Good.
I'm sorry. Do you know what you need right now?
Tell me what I need.
Hey, here's the fun police.
A very apologetic fun police. This sounds great.
Oh, man, that was... incredibly unsatisfying.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
That was the actual worst.
Yeah, we've just been like streaming the season finale of a favorite TV show, and then for some reason, on the couch, and our laptop ran out of battery in the last 5 minutes. We can't find our charger.
Yeah, and then mom walks in vacuum.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, dear. All right, well. We'll get it back this time.
And any tension is gone.
Yep.
You know what would be a
The
really,
moment's ruined.
Like a really fun thing. Like in those... When people watch now, they're expecting magic content, right? So you just watch the content and then you say like, oh, did you know also? And then you just spoil some random TV show.
Yes, I'm sure people would love that. We did that.
Yeah.
Just out of the blue. It's like, did you know that in the end of Lord of the Rings...
No, don't.
Lord of the Rings Lord of the Rings has only been around for, how many decades? Probably is it almost 100 years since The Hobbit was written? So it's been around a long time.
It sounds so horrible. You're just watching your favorite content, and somebody's like,
"That actually sounds horrible." And that's why we would never do it.
No, we would never say that Snape kills Dumbledore. We would never tell people that Vader is Luke's father. We'd never do that.
You know, maybe people are watching who haven't watched Harry Potter yet.
Okay, well, if they haven't watched it, maybe they should have read it, because it's been out for 10 years.
I think there's a high correlation between not having seen Harry Potter and no internet, so they can't watch us anyway.
What do we do here?
We definitely scry and want to find lava coil.
Okay. It's a very generic question.
What do we do here? End this Discord call, throw my computer out the window.
Yeah. What are we doing here?
Alright, no. That's a no for me.
That's a no from me, dog. Alright. Lava coil. Did you mean pirate's pillage?
I actually didn't mean pirate's pillage.
I did not. Alexa, draw lava coil.
This settler wreckage is very, very trustworthy.
Obvious?
No. Like, loyal.
Ah, yeah, because it's always in our hand, even though we only play one.
Just playing one, but it always turns up. So, hey guys,
Me really wonder why do we play some cards more than once, right? If you draw them conveniently enough.
Yeah, just play one.
That's how Toffel builds deck.
Yeah.
All the time.
I'm not surprised.
Even in limited.
This is a real stinker.
What?
This is going to make this a 3-5. Oh, no, it's not. Okay, good.
No, but why is 3-5 important?
Oh, well, I don't know. Okay. Well, I could just guess we're all in on settle.
Yeah, we are.
Should I kill this?
No. Just
okay. We're settling.
Yeah, I know, but it's still 3 damage.
I think we settled that.
Oh, I didn't. I didn't think it was settled.
That discussion still went on. You know, it's never. It's not suspicious at all if your opponent always scries during upkeep and then. Thinks and then just passes.
See, if we had like I don't know how this would work, but if we could somehow convey to our opponent, oh damn, we missed the upkeep stop again. Ugh, you know.
Mm.
But
wait for it. Right? Do you know those things where there's ships, right? The Titanic, for example, yeah? And they dive in, make like an expedition for the Titanic, and they found a different ship, but it's really old.
Yeah.
Right? Like. 200, 300 years, it's really old.
Okay.
So then they started arguing, like, how old is this ship? Like, it must be like 400 years old. And all those scientists, they go like, it's probably like 200, 300 old.
Interesting that you're talking about hundreds of years like this, Toffel, because this is how long it feels like this joke is going on for.
So, and then they finally came to a conclusion that it's like 500 years old, right? What did they do?
What do they do, Toffel?
I feel like it has something to do with...
It's awful. I'm so sorry. Check out this.
Wow. Even applause.
Yep. Even the viewers are applauding right now.
Yeah.
Yep. Discarding Lightning Strike. All the other cards have some use, probably. I feel like that was... I don't know.
Definitely not worth the wait.
I think it was very decent.
Very decent.
Not just decent,
extremely
ladies and gentlemen.
Decent.
No. He didn't say extremely decent. Just very decent.
Outstandingly decent.
Given my work with Richard Hagen over the years, I just I tend to just go blank when people are telling long convoluted magic puns.
I see, yeah.
Do we want this?
Not really.
Probably not, right?
Maybe.
Want some business here.
Rich I'm too distracted by jokes.
Did one of the best jokes ever made.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a bold claim, but let's see if you're right. Go on.
Do you want me to tell the whole joke?
Actually, probably not. I mean, is there a Cliff Notes version? Is there a shorter version of the joke?
No, you really need to
get the full experience. Yeah. All right. Well, if you ever see Toffel IRL or Rich, I'm sure he knows which one it is. All right, let's scroll.
Ask them about the best joke ever.
The best
made.
Joke
yeah,
he's ever told.
If you get it right, just ask him about like a Christmas story, about a rainy day, and a newspaper article.
That does sound like a good story.
It is a
I
good
think
story.
He made that up.
No. Now you want to listen to it? Don't you?
No.
I'm not particularly
you made
tempted.
That up and I know it.
Okay, you got it. So there's a. So the goal is to guess a card, right?
Okay, yep.
So there's a newspaper article, and we're looking for the headline. And the headline is a card. The newspaper article says, like, okay, it's Christmas Eve, and we have like a crime scene. There's the Santa Claus, and he found dead in a puddle. Yeah? Everything was soaking wet. Everything. But not his bag of gifts. That was totally dry. Absolutely. Yeah, and it was a Mysterium. Why is everything wet, but the back is dry? So the question was, and now comes the headline.
Okay.
And I give you a hint.
We're not going to guess.
I'm not going to guess.
We give you a hint. You can see the card on the screen. On your screen right now.
Yeah, nah. I really don't know.
Okay, the headline article is Sec Red Found Dry.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
No.
Nah.
No.
Amazing.
No.
Amazing.
No.
Amazing.
The opposite. No. In fact, the opposite.
No. That no.
No.
Beautiful.
No. No.
Luckily, our pond is dead next turn.
Yes.
While we also gain a squillion dice.
You know what? That game went over in a heartbeat.
I'm gonna put a little note at the beginning of this when I'm editing, being like, "Feel free to skip this one, guys. Nothing funny happens." All right. We've got enough mana for True Fire Captain.
Yeah. Just activate the Treasure Cove with the two counters on it. The treasure map, I mean. And then we should have enough mana.
All right. Probably have it. All right.
Yeah, we have one spare. Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Okay. All right. I'm so sorry, ladies and gentlemen, for that audio poison. But don't worry, because now we get a 20-hour opponent out of nowhere. I thought that we would have to work hard to 20-hour opponents.
Yeah.
It seems to actually be very easy.
But our aggro opponents never conceded after we like took over the game, which is very nice.
Yes, so,
like,
we appreciate it. Opponents. Yeah.
Shout out to our opponents, letting us do our thing.
Yep. Getcha.
Please don't concede now. Please
I
don't.
Mean, now we come on after
oh, spell pierce. One time spell pierce.
Oh my god!
Our opponent is just sitting there being like, "What is this? How can I be losing to this combo?"
And why does it have lifelink?
And why does it have lifelink?
It's like the real dinosaur flavor. They look to the sky, like, hey, "What is this?
What is this? Oh, that's very pretty. Ooh,
yeah. Oh, look, and shiny. It's shiny. It comes,
Oh, it's getting closer.
It's getting bigger and bigger.
Oh, I'm gonna have to take my jumper off here. It's getting a little bit warm."
Ooh, Merfolk will get very warm very quickly.
Well,
aren't they one of the people that survive?
Yeah, they can just dive under the water, but it's not going to save our opponent Merle here. Deader than disco. Take 20, my friend. Negative 4.
Go up to 91. Heal 20. What does this deck not do?
I think this is the overall highest life differentials that we've ever had, really.
Certainly.
All right. Ooh.
Woo!
A reward card. Oh, we'll never know what that card
was.
Time
to crack a little boosty D here. What do we got? Boosty big D. Money. The biggest Ooh, money. The biggest
the
money
biggest
there
money.
Is. All right. That was like a 500 euro note.
All right. Let's continue on with our journey through the constructed event.
Yeah, man.
We're only two wins away. Guys, control decks look to answer early threats and survive until the late game. I think that's what we're doing.
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
Right now.
Yeah.
Man, oh, I didn't know. Well,
This is actually a control deck. I mean, it's a control deck with a combo finish, basically.
Mate, we're playing 4-mana, 4-3. We're getting in there.
Yeah, exactly. All right, you want to keep this?
Yes, for sure.
Yeah, let's keep this. Good hand.
Revitalize is basically like treasure map.
Essentially.
Not really.
Well, it's better because it gains you 3 life rather than drawing you 3 cards.
Oh, yes, of course.
So is that Teferi on Revitalize?
I don't think Teferi would be like huddling down behind a wall under a thing of arrows. He'd just be like, "See ya, time magic, back to
yeah," and then teleport behind them and
yeah,
nothing personal.
Very good. I really like that. There's a healing potion in Magic, though.
Is there? What's the flavor text? Can we see it? A potion is no substitute for a skilled surgeon. But it will hold your bits in.
As in, like, you can take your bits, like in the Ocarina of Time, you can put your bits into the bottle, like into the potion bottle.
Do you think that bottle will hold Twitch bits? Because you can cheer on Twitch.
Yeah, that's right. I wonder how many bits you could get into this bottle. It's got a very thin.
Probably like 300 at least.
It's got a very narrow neck though, doesn't it?
Yeah, like they don't spill out all at once.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, they just kind of fall on top of it and then go on the floor, make a big mess.
You can't cheer 300. Instantly.
Yeah, because like... it'll quite literally bottleneck. So our opponent is timing out on their mulligan decision, so they must have a real interesting hand here. Let's talk about this card.
Pirates pillage.
Because
do we want to talk about the artwork? Because that artwork is hilarious.
Yes. What is this little monkey fellow doing? Is this like a jewel that's the eye of the, in the eye of the dragon here that he's trying to get out?
Yeah, dragon. Definitely. That's how the song goes.
I think it's
isn't that usually just triggering a lot of traps?
Oh yeah.
Yes. I mean, how genre blind is this little goblin here? Sweet. Easy game. Easy game. The
deck is too strong.
And that's the end of another episode of the Arena Boys Lore World. Join us next time as we discuss the flavor text and the art of another card. But in the meantime, guys, one more. This is it.
Yeah. It's the final one.
It's the final one.
Oh, we're playing against Euler.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, mate. I would try to think of something funny that has to do with Euler's number, but it's not really related to magic, I guess.
Do you know, I think Euler was very stupid to have Euler's number be so, like, weird and hard to remember. Cause it's,
yeah, he should have just made it three.
Well, that's it. It's
not,
like,
it's not that hard to remember.
Okay, go.
What do you mean, the number?
Yeah, the number,
yeah.
Go.
Yeah, 2.718281828.
4590453. Okay, the point is...
No, but the thing is, behind the eight, it gets complicated.
Oh, right.
Wow, I thought that Toffel just made things up here. But, like, the first four digits, or whatever I could remember, are actually true. It's 2.71821.
Yeah, it's 1828-1828.
It's like a phone. Like a phone number.
8281828. 4590453536.
This is...
Oh. 2, 8, 7, 4, 9.
What I would do though, as you said, Jamin, like if I were to have a number, like if there were to be Riley's number, I wouldn't make it hard to remember. I would just have one.
Oh
yeah, of course.
And then when anyone wanted one of anything, so how many do you want? Oh, just Riley's number. Like
that's very dumb.
Imagine having the number one named after you, basically.
Mm-hmm. Imagine being named one.
That would be pretty bad. That would be pretty bad. What's the best name you've ever that you've ever met has had?
Jamin.
Okay, well, Toffel.
The best that a person has?
Yeah, because I've got one that's gonna blow you out of the water here. I met a oh wow, okay, very aggressive. Is that opponent just on? Oh, no,
they're on the ultimate flat out.
How can we beat Miscloaked Herald? Our opponent letting us know that this one is in the bag for them.
Wait, they never played anything? How? What did they have?
I think
their starting hand must have been horrific.
It must have been a real stinker here.
I imagine there is at least one of the enchantment in there that gives +1/+1, so we should probably kill the...
I was going to say, we're swimming in removal here. Anyway, many years ago, when I was traveling around the US, all right, that's fine, I couch surfed with some people. One of whom was named, and this is not a joke, I checked, it's on his license. Cannon was his first name, right?
Oh god, no, no.
Yeah, yeah,
no.
Yeah, yeah. And you think, like already you're thinking that's pretty good. Like we're off to a really good start with Cannon, right?
Yeah.
It only got better from there. Do you know what his last name was?
Ball.
Huge.
Oh!
His name was Cannon Huge, which means that on everything that had, like, you know, on like school, the school roll, and everywhere where your last name comes before your
magic
name,
pairings.
Exactly. On magic pairings, you would go to the pairings board and see that you were being paired against Huge Cannon.
Wow.
I mean, how can you ever win that?
Yeah, you just have like 10% going into the match.
That's it, before you've even sat down or rolled the die. Anyway, if you're watching, Cannon. It's been like 10 years, but I hope you're doing well. I slept in your bed one time when you were away. I hope you don't mind. You got a really comfortable bed.
And a really huge can.
And a really huge can. Jamin!
I'm sorry.
Keep your smut out of this show. This is a family-friendly show. How dare you? How dare you? All right.
No, dry land.
No, okay.
Drawing land would have been
I'll
nice.
Just cast this.
Yeah.
I mean, they probably knew, right? At the point where they did all of this naming thing. That this is...
Oh, yeah. We will gift unto you, son, a world, an entire universe of the funniest jokes money can buy. just cast this.
Whatever you want. You
can... Whatever I want. I'll cast Intervention, yeah. Targeting myself.
Well, that was one of the options.
Yeah. there's actually a similar joke for my name, because in my last name is Kauf. And in German, what does that mean, Riley?
It means buy mean in German? Or purchase. Buy or purchase.
Yeah, exactly. To purchase. So whenever, like, in school, when my last name was called first, it would be Purchase Jamin.
Kauf Jamin.
Yeah, exactly.
I already knew that mountain was on top.
Yep.
Powerful. Somehow, I don't think it'll matter.
Not really.
Are we doing it again?
We're doing it again. Course. We're going to close out this video with another 20 damage to the dome. I thought that we would have to, really scrape for it. I thought we'd have to do extra games and like figure out exactly how we're going to get there and all that sort of stuff. So I flip this first, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
If we draw land, you don't. Yeah.
I'll just scribe because then we can play our own spell pierce. Yeah. Although, two spell pierces.
That would be extremely...
And we're in trouble, but it's all right, because there's another star on the way. I'll get rid of that.
We need a land.
Yeah, we need a land over here. All right, draw.
No land, but still.
Whatever.
It's star
Can we
time.
Just wait?
No.
No. Never. I'm never taking that advice off you again, Toffel. It is time to close things out. Get it done. Good game from the opponent. Star of Extinction. Get you dead.
Getting star pierces is just so bad.
No!
Oh, they did it! They did it! Oh, that's really cool.
Oh, no.
Well, I guess we stone-rained our opponent.
I guess we stone-rained our opponent and
traded a 2-2 for a 4-3.
That was beautiful.
Yeah, well done, opponent.
That truly was beautiful.
And another Merfolk Trickster. How can we ever win?
That was the best down win play I've ever seen.
Yeah. Yep. We got gotten, as they say.
We did get gotten. Yeah, that's how you say it, I think.
But now we get to sit a little maths exam with this.
Oh yeah, we do.
Yeah.
So now, question. How much?
Oh
no! Nope, turns out we don't. Wow.
Okay, so
how many times can you get gotten?
Twice, apparently. Maybe more.
Apparently. Maybe we'll. I don't know what the upper limit is on the getting gotten.
The question is, how much life do you gain if you cast Integrity Intervention or Intervention with a Firesong and Sunspeaker out?
Is it A, 6 life, or B, 9 life, or C, 12 life? Or
I'll say 9 life.
18 life.
And I probably messed something up somewhere. So it's not going to be 9 life.
Good. Did you... Were you all one of those people that did like a math question, right? And then go like, okay, my solution is like A, but A seems low. Let's do B.
No, I was actually very good in math in school. This Tempest Djinn is actually surprisingly scary.
No, it's not. We can kill it with this.
Oh, yes. Because Oh.
Or with
oh.
This.
Or with that.
Okay. Yeah. So if we cast Deafening Clarion with both modes and then cast Intervention, how much life do we gain overall?
Let's find out.
24.
I'll take 27.
All right, I'll take 22.
I like how you wanted to pick 25, but realized it's not multiples of three.
Okay, so we're on 18. I've got 22.
Yeah.
You've got 27. And Toffel, you have 20.
I can
24. All
right. Oh wait, but the attack does count. Man, Oh, I want to count with 3.
No, it's 9. Wait,
no, it's 12.
What is even happening?
We don't know. We wait for Arena. Wait, so
why do we gain life twice?
Because it has lifelink.
Okay.
Exactly. Okay. It's so complicated, and I'm really glad we don't have to think about anything. I really like how our opponent flashed in a 2-2 in response.
How did we end up on 24?
Yeah,
is it 24? Whoa!
No, you said we'd gain 24. No.
Nobody listened to that.
Doesn't count.
How did we gain 7 life in that exchange?
We didn't. We gained 6. We're on 18.
Oh, okay. Yep. I thought we were in 17.
No, no, no.
Okay.
No. Yeah, intervention is just in there to make things very hard to keep track of. That's the only reason it's in the list.
If our opponent plays a creature in the next two turns, we have to star, right?
Why?
Right.
To gain 40 life.
Yeah, but I want to win the game. I'm busy. I've got stuff to do.
Look at boring Riley.
I've got things to do, mate. I've got people to see, places to go. I'm a busy man.
I would give this interaction 2-star.
All right. Well, Deafening Clarion will probably clean things up.
Yeah, play it.
I would have played it pre-combat.
Play it now.
Just pass, whatever.
Doesn't do anything. What are you talking about? It doesn't do
it
anything.
It kills our opponent.
Why? We don't... Oh, because we would gain life off that? No.
Yeah.
No. Yes,
of course.
It doesn't... Right. Oh, because it deals damage to that. Okay, all right. Yeah, you're right. Okay. This is the weirdest way I've ever won a game. Deafening Clarion, my 4-6 to deal 3 damage to your face. Well, we did it, boys. Easy game, 7-2. Lost game 1, always lose game 1. That's the Arena Boys tradition. A proud tradition it is too. Oh, the Ultimate Fighter.
The Ultimate Fighter. The Ultimate Post Office Worker.
Yeah.
And let's see what we got.
Yeah.
Great. Just what I've been looking for.
Perfect.
Okay. Well, this does scream Arena Boys.
Kind of, right?
It does.
Like, we have to someone.
Because he's erratic.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And like has very bad tunnel vision. And yeah. Okay. Woo. Well, that's all right. Whatever. Thanks for a bit of artificial hype there. You mean? Anyway, that's probably that's just about that for this week. I reckon a pretty good day in the office. That one went a little bit better than I thought it was going to.
Amazing.
Like, this deck was really good against aggro decks.
Yeah.
Incredible.
I thought we would have to, like, sort of keep, you know, really, really scrape to get the 20 damage combo. I thought we would have to try hard to get 300 life in with Star of Extinction and Firesong and Sunspeaker. But as it turns out, easy game. Can't be beaten. This deck's unbeatable.
Yeah, deck's unbeatable. Deck always 20s the opponent.
Yep, easy. Easy. That's that. If you want to get across the list in further detail, channelfireball.com, of course, there'll be a deck guide going up in the coming days. But thanks so much for watching another Arena Boys video. It's been great to hang out with you. And thanks so much for all the feedback that we're getting. It is, without any irony, it's heart-melting to read how kind people are about this video series. And we all really, really appreciate you taking the time to hang out with us and leave comments in the section below. We are going to close things out, though. If you want to get in touch with us directly, you can tweet at us, at The Arena Boys. It's a good way to send through any decks, especially anything with Ravnica Allegiance. If you've got a spicy brew on the boil, we're very, very interested in hearing about it, and we'll be happy to take it out for a spin once the cards obviously arrive in the coming days. If you want to contact any of us individually as well, or just follow us on Twitter, you can find me at Riley Query Tower. Every week.
So I dozed off a little.
Say it.
Add Toffel MTG.
All right, we got there. Finally.
And goodness. Add Jack the Mattress.
I feel like in the end, it's just a part where I get edited in.
Yeah. We should just record you doing it once, and then I can just edit that same soundbite in.
I will never say it again. I feel like.
I can just use one of the old ones. If you ever hear a very familiar sounding outro, then you know that it's just been recycled. Anyway, that's that for another week. Please do get in touch with any deck list you've got for Ravnica Allegiance. We're very excited to get underway with a new set, but that's that for this week. We will see you again next week with more Arena Boys. Until then, it's time to exit the arena.
Boys!